Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night to many of you out there in this world. We need to come together as brothers and sisters, uniting together on one front, and that is the prayer for each and every one of us. So this day, I would like to challenge each and every one of you to a national prayer challenge and forgiveness. That we come to a point not only to pray, but to forgive one another and to unite together as a whole. Everything in this world has ears and it can hear, no matter what it is, no matter we believe or not believe. But I speak right now into the ears of the coronavirus, asking it to leave us and to not to return. But today, brothers and sisters, we're going to gather today for this national prayer challenge, and we will begin to pray for one another. Everybody makes their own video, and they begin to pray, not just for your family, not just for your wife and kids, not just for your community, but to pray for the world, to really sincerely go within your hearts and to pray for this world. For those brothers and sisters who want to pick up gun, leave the guns behind and let's go to the point to pick up the word of God. Let's go to a point where we don't let greed and selfishness rule over us, because now we should more than anything take the time to get to know one another and to find out what we can do to help each other. Because this within itself could be yet a test to see just how selfish we can be as people, to see how cruel and disheartening we can be as people. But I challenge you this day, let's make a difference. Let's come together and pray. I've never been the type of person who looked for 15 minutes of fame. All of my life, I've hid from others. I didn't like to take pictures. I didn't like to do things of this nature because I always wanted to be incognito, not to be seen, not to be known. But I stepped forth through this challenge to ask you, let's bless one another. And I pray right now that in the name of Jesus, not to offend anyone who doesn't have a belief in Christ, but whatever you pray or to whomever you pray to, I ask you right now, let's pray. It is in Jesus' name that we give you the praise, the honor, and the glory, God, for blessing us, to unite us together, that we will come to you in thanksgiving and praise, praying, Father God, that you forgive us. Forgive us from all our transgression. Forgive us for our sins, Father God. Forgive us for all the things that we have done. Forgive us, Lord, for the things that we seek, O Heavenly Father, with our own self-righteousness. We ask that you open up our hearts. Pour your blessing and your Holy Spirit within us and help us to guide, lead, and to keep us in the name of Jesus. Father God, protect us from all hurt, harm, evil, and danger. And let us, Heavenly Father, look to you which cometh our help. And that we will be so quick, Father God, to spread the love, Father God, that you have given us and to give it to others. We thank you for all you do, and we thank you now, Father God, for bringing an end to the coronavirus, and Heavenly Father, blessing us that we can begin again and become a new creature, Father God. This is for all my sisters and brothers throughout this entire universe. For those who have ears that are willing to hear, Father God, I pray for them, and I ask each and every one of us to pray that we will unite together more than we did for Desert Storm, Father God, more than we did for any other catastrophe or any other thing in this world. I ask that you forgive us, you guide us, lead us, and keep us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.